Everybody, the sun, it's the source of all life, and it could mean the end of life as we know it. NASA did a study, and its findings are now out. We're not talking about global warming. A brand new government study on the very real destructive threat of solar storms. Check it out. The surface of the sun, a roiling mass of plasma and charged high-energy particles. As we move to the launch pad, we can show exactly what we mean, escaping the surface of the sun and traveling through space to areas down here on Earth. Now, this giant fireball, if that ball hit the Earth and its magnetic shield, it would be devastating. I want to show you New York City at night. Times Square, drove through here at 8 o'clock last night. Streets are empty, but the electric power grid would be wiped out by the current. Lights and computers, transportation, hospitals, all would go down. The study warns it would be a disaster, far worse than anything we have seen before. The menace of these sunstorms poses a bigger threat to more high-tech and advanced countries like the U.S. Everything from our sewage systems to our Wall Street banks operate with our power grid. And a game-changing solar storm that could hit at any time. So how worried should we be? Sounds like we should be. Michio Kaku is an astrophysicist and author of The Physics of the Impossible. Sir, good morning to you. Welcome back here.
Glad to be on your show.
Now, what I'm reading here scares me to death. Should I be that way?
That's right. We're talking about a potential Katrina from outer space. Katrina caused about $100 billion in property damage. And unless we begin to make efforts now to reinforce our satellites and power grid, we could have something maybe 10 times bigger than Katrina, because we're talking about the loss of all electricity and all satellite activity. We'd be thrown 100 years back into the past.
Michio, has this happened before?
In 1859, we had a humongous storm that wiped out telegraph poles, and we tried to then estimate what kind of power could do that. And we now realize that we are very young in the space age. If something like the 1859 storm hit again, it would literally paralyze all the United States, not just for a day or an hour, but for months to years. Our transformers would short circuit and burn out. Satellites would be fried to a crisp. And the sun, however, has these storms every 11 years. Every 11 years, the magnetic field flips. But in 2012, we do expect perhaps another big one.
Well, we have never before in our history, in human history for that matter, relied so much on technology as we do today. And that's part of what they found in the study, because we rely so much on our ability to communicate through our computers that they would all go down, which would handicap not just New York, but really the eastern half of the United States. That's what the study finds, which would be far worse than the blackout of New York from 4 years ago, Michio.
That's right. Those blackouts only last for a few hours to a day. But if you start to short circuit all the transformers and blow out the satellites and fry the communications grid, then you're talking about knocking out the United States for months before we can get enough rescue crews and repairmen to handle not just one city, but hundreds of cities around the United States.
You know, Michio, sometimes you come on here and you sound like the doctor of doom and gloom. Does something like this keep you up at night?
It does, and I think with Katrina, you know, engineers knew that Katrina could happen, but they did nothing because they said that it's not going to happen while I'm around. Well, now we learned the lesson. You have to prepare for things, especially when you know that at some point it's inevitable that we're going to have another big one, like we had back in 1859, except this time we're totally dependent on electricity.
Michio, thank you. Hope to see you in person next time. We'll take you on the phone if we can. Michio Kaku, thank you for your time today. 1859. I mean, we're going back 150 years on that, Megan. Now he's wondering about 2012. Watch for this story.